Merry Dogs, Crafts on More 4. Brought to you by Yukonuba.
I always see those stats and I just think, how come Archie, my dog, can't do any of those things? I'm sure it will come to him in time, and I'm sure many of you think your dogs are the cleverest things on the planet, and they probably are. But you also sometimes get frustrated with trying to train them to do the basics and trying to make sure they're obedient, particularly in stressful situations. So how do you get the best out of your dog? Well, the woman to answer that question is Victoria Stillwell.
Most of the dogs here at Crufts are well behaved. But what can you do at home to ensure your dog has good manners and listens to you? Well, that's where positive training comes in.
Yeah, this is a story of Ben's dog. But the dog that chases its tail.
The great thing about positive training is it really builds up a language of communication between you and your dog, as well as fosters a bond between you. And I like to use rewards. Rewards make a dog feel good. And I use food, praise, toys, play, whatever the dog is motivated by. And positive training really encourages dogs to learn. So what I'm going to teach Molly here is just a simple targeting technique. I'm going to put my hand out and she has to touch her nose to my hand and then I give her the treat. Here we go. Molly. Good girl. Good girl. I call it the touch cue. Touch. Good girl. And what's really great about this cue is that it teaches dogs to target your hand, to touch your hand, which is great for recall. So for example, if you've got a dog that you want to come to you, all you have to do is to stick out your hand, say touch, and your dog runs to you. Here we go. Touch. Good girl, Molly. Good girl. If you teach a dog like a Newfoundland, the leave it cue, make sure that you have a slobber cloth handy. I'm working here with Skye. Skye has a bit of a penchant for food. So what I'm doing is that, good girl, I am waiting for Skye to move her head away from the treat. Good, before she gets it. At the moment, I'm not asking her to do anything. I'm getting her to think and figure out for herself how she's gonna get this treat out of my hand. Good. When you first start teaching a dog any cue, use any reward that motivates the dog most. But after a while, start to vary the rewards, because if a dog's food motivated, for example, you don't want the dog to only work for food. You want the dog to work for any kind of reward, such as praise or play or toys, or even just a simple reward as, hey, if you sit by the door, I'm going to open the door and let you go for a walk. You're a great trainer. If you had two positive training tips for the viewers at home, what would they be?
My first one would be that positive training works on every dog, regardless of the breed.
For reactive dogs, the good news is that we can use positive training methods with these reactive dogs to get great results.
To teach dogs to be able to make their own choices and their own decisions, because they have to be free to decide things for themselves.
It doesn't matter the age, breed, or issue you have with your dog, there's always a place for positive training.
Just so good, Victoria.